So, you're ready for higher frame rates than what 1GB cameras can offer. But jumping all the way to 10GB is a little overkill for you. That's where the Atlas 5GB camera comes in, hitting the sweet spot right down the middle. Atlas 5GB camera and the Atlas IP67 5GB camera, both Gigi Vision and GeniCam compliant cameras. Let's talk about what makes them so great and dive a little deeper into the 5GB interface and its benefits. For those looking for higher frame rates and higher Ethernet camera bandwidth, the Atlas camera provides a bandwidth of up to 600 megabytes per second for streaming images, 5 times the bandwidth of 1GB cameras. The Atlas cameras and the Atlas IP67 cameras feature Sony sensors. However, the sensors available between the two are different, and we'll get into that in a second. But first, let's talk about the main feature of these cameras, the 5GB interface. 5GB, also known as 5GBASE-T, is part of the NBASE-T Ethernet standard. The NBASE-T standard was specifically designed to allow Ethernet devices to run at 5GBASE-T and 2.5GBASE-T speeds, while also being backwards compatible with Cat5e and Cat6 cabling. There are various versions to Ethernet cabling, with Cat6a and Cat7 being the most modern, but Cat5e and Cat6 cabling has been around for a very long time, and it makes up the vast majority of cabling installed in network applications, commercial and industrial buildings, and other infrastructure. For application designers, this is a huge time-saving step, as it allows them the ability to upgrade their application by swapping in a faster 5GB camera without having to rip out and rewire their Ethernet application. Imagine an entire factory floor that's equipped with Cat 5e or 6 cabling for their Ethernet Vision application. This means they don't have to open up the walls or climb into the ceilings and pull out and rewire the entire factory, which would cause quite a bit of interruption and additional manpower costs. For vision designers new to 5GB, the major benefits, as mentioned earlier, is that it offers bandwidth of around 600 megabytes per second at 100 meter cable lengths over Cat6 cabling. Of course, you can use Cat6a or Cat7 cables, but overall cabling costs for 5GB remains very low. In addition, the Atlas cameras can not only run at 5GB speeds, but also at 2.5GB and 1GB speeds if necessary. They also feature power over Ethernet, so you can use a single cable for both power and data. Now, before 5GB existed for machine vision cameras, one of the more popular interfaces for cameras to use to get higher bandwidth than 1GB was to use USB 3.0, also known as USB 3.1 Gen 1 and officially now known as USB 3.2 Gen 1x1. These cameras are known as USB 3 Vision cameras in the machine vision space. In comparison to USB 3 Vision, however, 5GB offers 50% higher bandwidth and much longer cable lengths, with USB 3 Vision cameras maxing out at around 400 megabytes per second with a max cable length of only around 4 or 4.5 meters. Another thing to note is that overall, the Ethernet interface is designed to be very resilient in an industrial environment. It's much less prone to noise and EMI issues, as its signaling operates at a much lower rate, around 500 megahertz or lower compared to many electronic devices that operate RF signals in the 2.5 gigahertz range, which has been known to interfere with some USB 3 Vision cameras. Hazardous voltage changes and ground loop currents from different ground potentials between industrial equipment can also affect devices. Ethernet, however, uses transformers on both sides of the connection, effectively isolating connected devices so Ethernet cameras don't share common ground. Ethernet is also very flexible when it comes to building a multi-machine vision camera system thanks to a wide range of available network switches and interface card options, along with long-distance cabling and 1588 precision time protocol synchronization. All of these Ethernet benefits apply to our Atlas 5GB cameras. In comparison to 10GB, yes, you're only getting half the bandwidth compared to 1.2 gigabytes per second bandwidth, and we do have 10GB cameras, the Atlas 10, but that's for a different video. So in comparison to 10GB, 5GB cameras though do cost less, have lower power consumption, are more compact, and their demands on network and PC system resources, such as RAM, CPU, and SSD speeds, are lower compared to 10GB. So for those application designers where 10GB is too much of a jump, but 1GB is too slow, the Atlas cameras offer a nice middle ground that's cost-effective with a great balance between price, performance, and reliability. All right, let's talk about the differences between the two versions. Starting with the non-IP67 models. These models feature Sony Pregius Gen 2 and Gen 3 sensors, ranging from 2.8 megapixels up to 31.4 megapixels, with the three highest resolution models using large format sensors. While the models from 2.8 to 12.3 use C-mount lens mounts, the three high resolution models use a TFL lens mount. TFL mount is a published lens mount standard that fills the gap between C-mount and F-mount sizes. It offers better corner illumination for 4/3-inch and APS-C sensors, reducing illumination issues created from steep ray angles compared to C-mount. It also offers a more ruggedized lens connection for the camera compared to F-mount, as the threaded screw mount of the TFL mount provides vastly stronger clamping force compared to the bayonet connection of F-mount. This eliminates wobble or sag even when vibration is present, which can be quite common in an industrial environment. Of course, if you want to use an F-mount lens, we do have TFL mount to F-mount adapters. Moving on to the IP67 models. As the name states, these models have dust and water protection. These models contain a mixture of Sony Pregius Gen 2, Gen 3, and Gen 4 sensors, along with a 20 megapixel rolling shutter Sony Starvis sensor. But none of the large format models of the non-IP67 Atlas. Instead, those are replaced with high-resolution Sony Pregius Gen 4 sensors, which have a smaller pixel size and smaller sensor sizes, allowing for all IP67 models to use just C-mount. Another way of looking at these models is that they closely mirror some of our 1GB Triton IP67 camera models. This means that our Atlas IP67 models and the corresponding Triton IP67 models can share the same lenses and same lens tubes between them. This is helpful for Triton customers who are looking for an easier upgrade path for their IP67 application, but don't want to have to respec for a new lens or a new lens tube. No matter what model you get, all models go through active sensor alignment during manufacturing, greatly reducing any sensor tilt or rotation, giving you crisp and clear images from the center of the sensor to the edges and for each and every unit. This is particularly important for those higher resolution, larger sensor format Atlas models. Both models have an M12 8-pin X-coated Ethernet connector and M8 GPIO connector. Comparing overall size, the IP67 models are a tad larger compared to the non-IP67 models. As with all of our cameras, the Atlas comes with our free Arena software development kit, as well as support for many of the popular third-party software packages. So, in conclusion, the Atlas cameras offer a wide variety of sensor choices between our non-IP67 and IP67 models. The 5GB interface with PoE allows you to stream around 600 megabytes per second over 100 meters of Cat5e cabling. While it's only half as fast as 10GB, it comes with a lower price point with lower network and system requirements. It's also faster than USB 3 Vision cameras and has all of the industrial benefits that Ethernet has to offer. All right, to check out the full Atlas camera details, visit our website at thinklucid.com. Thanks so much for watching and stay lucid.